You're watching UNICEF television. The harsh sun has dried out Aisha Adum's tomatoes, okra and berries. She picks off the stems and breaks the tomatoes in half, preparing them for market. It's the dry season in N'Djamena, the capital of Chad. Dust, coats, everything. And while lakes and rivers are low and polluted, they still provide respite from the heat. Clean water is in high demand, but poor quartiers on the outskirts aren't on the city's grid and rely on shallow wells and, if they can afford it, water vendors to provide water for drinking and bathing. But even then, there's no guarantee that the water is clean. Last year, over 17,000 people contracted cholera in Chad, and there were almost 5,000 cases in the capital alone. Aisha Adum and her family live in Dar es Salaam, a poor quartier on the edge of N'Djamena. She used to use much of her income to buy one or two jerry cans of water a week. It was all she could afford, but it still wasn't enough.
It was so expensive, we couldn't buy enough water for everything, so we would just buy one or two jerry cans for drinking and cooking. But for other things like washing, we would use dirty water, and there was a lot of disease and a lot of diarrhea in the children.
But last year, UNICEF, in partnership with Secours Islamique France, started building clean water delivery systems in poor communities around N'Djamena. The wells are 60 meters deep, far deeper and thus far cleaner than the open or even hand-pumped wells commonly used here. The harsh, incessant sun provides the power. Solar panels fuel the pumps which suck up and deliver water to an elevated tank, which in turn feeds two water points. Aisha and her family live right across the road from one of them. It's changed their lives.
Before, it was so expensive to buy water. But now, since this was installed, my daughter, my grandchildren and I go to collect water whenever we want. It's so much better for us.
There are now seven such water points in poor quartiers around N'Djamena, managed by the communities in which they've been built. While the water is free for individual households, water vendors pay a minimum amount, which is then used for service, maintenance and chlorination. The water vendors themselves don't have to travel as far to source water and can now provide a cleaner, healthier product.
People in this quartier keep telling us stories about how they always used to get diarrhea and how they used to get cholera. But since this was installed, there hasn't been one case of cholera here.
Alongside the installation of water systems, UNICEF and Secours Islamique France have also built latrines in public places like markets and schools. It's an attempt to cut down on open defecation, which aids the spread of bacterial diseases like cholera. Like the water systems, the latrines are managed by the community and people are charged a small fee for their use. The money is used for the upkeep and maintenance of the latrines and for buying soap.
The involvement of communities is so important because it makes them and the projects independent, which then allows our organization to work in other places, because they're now autonomous.
Access to safe drinking water and sanitation services in Chad is among the lowest in the world, and are major factors in the recurrent outbreaks of diseases like polio, meningitis, and, persistently, cholera. It's only through the delivery of quality sanitation services and, most importantly, clean water that Chad can hope to overcome this vicious cycle of disease.
If you talk about life, you talk about water, but not just water, clean water, and now we have clean water.
This is Guy Hubbard reporting for UNICEF Television. For more information, go to unicef.org. Unite for Children.